Sachin Pilot, you know, one of the arguments that has been made here just this evening on this program is that states and the center don't need separate laws to deal with lynching, although the Supreme Court had actually ordered that last year, and we're not seeing much movement as far as the center is concerned. But why did Rajasthan decide that it needed a separate law to deal with this when you do have existing provisions that could have done the same?
Okay, first we have to acknowledge the fact that across the country there have been many instances of mob lynching. Now this is actually a new development. It is not something that has been happening prior to last 4 years. And I think there are enough laws in our statute to deal with it. Law and order is a state subject. But the specific act of mob lynching has come to light in the recent past, and the incidences are going unabated. In fact, the people who are accused of these crimes are very rarely punished, and once the news is off the headlines, it just subsides into the background. I think the Rajasthan government and we all collectively made up our minds that we have to give a very strong message. Enacting the law is only one part of the solution. Other is execution, and Nidhi, frankly speaking, a government is judged on how it deals with the crime once we have the government structures in place. It's not about passing a bill or enacting a law alone. It's also important for the people, the society and the community to know that if you deviate from the law, yes, you should be taken to task, but who should be that agency? It should be the police, the judiciary and the government of the day. It cannot be a group of people who decide to deliver justice there and then. And that's exactly what's happening on basis of suspicion, race, gender, caste, religion, language. People are being discriminated and beaten to death. So therefore, this law will actually, I think, safeguard the interests of those people who are the most vulnerable. And it's important for the country and the people to know that there are governments that are sensitive to this. The courts have made it very clear that they're against any of these instances of mob lynching. Therefore, we're acting A, in response to that, and B, as a political party, we have committed ourselves that we can't accept this in a civil society and we must act and act promptly.
The question, though, is, Sachin Pilot, how will you ensure the implementation is there on the ground in letter and spirit? Again, all laws are actually, you know, meant to have a greater good that they aim for. But it ultimately comes down to policing and what happens on the ground when a situation is presented before authorities. Therefore, is it enough to say we've introduced a new law without ensuring that the implementation will take place?
I think any law that is enacted is done with the best interest in mind. It's not for or against a community, a religion, even a sentiment. I think it's there to ensure that there is counterbalance to the kinds of incidences we've seen, whether it's Jharkhand or Delhi or Rajasthan or whatever. I think the act is important, but it also gives teeth and it gives a sense of warning to those elements who have indulged in these activities before.